In terms of judicial developments, it is striking and noteworthy that well over two centuries since the founding, the Supreme Court has never suggested that the Second Amendment protects an individual right to have guns. Not once. It would be amazing, though, given that fact, though don't be surprised, if the first time it happens is in the next 3 or 4 years.
I want to get right to the controversial issue that I raised in my opening statement before exploring other issues with you. In a 2007 speech, you said, and I quote, "We ought to ban hunting." Now, that was just one speech, but then in doing a search through some of your documents and legal articles, we also found a statement saying we might ban hunting altogether, at least if its sole purpose is human recreation. First, let me say that you certainly have the right to have any view on hunting that you wish. My concern as someone who represents a state where hunting and fishing and the outdoors are very much part of our heritage, that you not take steps, if you are confirmed, to try to influence regulation in such a way that it would affect the decisions that individuals make in conformance with state and local laws on whether or not to hunt. Can you give me assurances that if you're confirmed, you will not seek to implement your personal view that hunting should be banned?
Yes, Senator, I can pledge that to you in the strongest possible terms. The only thing I'd add is that the law is authoritative, first. Second, I'm a strong believer in the Second Amendment to the United States Constitution. I'm on record as saying that the Second Amendment protects the right to hunt. That reflects my own personal view.
Coming view is that the individual right to bear arms reflects the success of an extremely aggressive and resourceful social movement and has much less to do with good standard legal arguments than appears. We have seen an unbelievable transformation in the culture of the Second Amendment in a short time. As late as the early 1990s.
A fascist lawyer from the University of Chicago Law School, a mentor of Obama, Cass Sunstein, and I'm using the words very selectively, he is a fascist legal scholar of the most dangerous kind, has just been appointed regulatory czar of the United States of America. My good friend Professor Ellis Washington has written an article on Cass Sunstein called The Heartlessness of Ideas, which will be up tomorrow, in which he goes into the background of this man, and you have to understand what Obama's doing to you. Yesterday, Cass Sunstein was confirmed by a Senate vote of 57-40 as the new Director of Regulatory Affairs and Information. Now you say, what the heck does that do? He regulates all laws, past, present, and future. Regulates all laws. He can rewrite them. And the fact of the matter is, this man is going to rewrite the history of America. Now, you knew that last week Van Jones got thrown out because he was very dangerous, and he was a very, very dangerous man and slipped into the White House by Obama. He got thrown out. But the far more dangerous man is Cass Sunstein, who believes animals should be allowed to sue their owners. He believes that the Second Amendment should be eliminated. He believes in so many things that are bizarre, you'd ask yourself, how could Obama have appointed him to such a position? The answer is because Obama sat at the feet of Sunstein at the University of Chicago. just as he sat at the feet of Reverend Wright for 20 years and then said he didn't know Reverend Wright was saying those things. He sat at the feet of this man for so many years at Chicago, and he hopes he will one day be on the Supreme Court. Rumor has it that Obama is grooming this Sunstein character as a future Supreme Court justice. We learn that Sunstein is to the left even of Ruth Bader Ginsburg. He says so many things that are akin with Mussolini and Mao Zedong that our very freedom itself is at stake. And yet there was hardly a ripple in the media when this moral faker, Cass Sunstein, was ushered into this most powerful of all positions. And Ellis Washington writes, because people ascribe a degree of respectability to academics, intellectuals, philosophers, and scholars, they can disregard the rights of the people much easier than a naked tyrant. He said, in fact, Rousseau, Darwin, and Nietzsche can go places that Hitler, Stalin, Chavez, and Obama could never dream. And so here we have Cass Sunstein, now in charge of all laws, regulations rather, past, present, and future. The man is a clear and present danger to your freedom.